Welcome to the video Basics Reconstruction. In the previous video about basic sampling, we have discussed the basic sampling theorem, which goes as follows. When a continuous time input signal x of t contains frequencies which are all below a maximum frequency fmax, we can reconstruct via a D2C converter this continuous time signal x of t without aliasing by its discrete time samples x of n when these samples are obtained via a C to D converter which runs at a sample rate fs which is greater than 2 times the maximum frequency fmax. If we sample at a sampling rate which is too low, we obtain aliasing. Ideally, the reconstruction by the D2C converter selects only frequencies inside the fundamental interval, which are frequencies up to fs over 2. The question is, how can we reconstruct the continuous time signal x of t from the discrete time samples x of n? Is it possible, or correct, to simply replace the integral index n by fs times t? The answer is that this is only possible in theory, when we have a mathematical expression of the samples of the sinusoidal signal, and the relative frequency theta 0 is inside the fundamental interval. For such a case, we first substitute the relative frequency theta 0 by 2 pi f0 divided by fs, and then replace n by fs multiplied by t, and the result is that the relative frequency theta 0 has been mapped to the absolute frequency f0, which is smaller than fs over 2. In case the relative frequency theta 0 is outside the fundamental interval range, which is the result of a C to D converted signal with an absolute frequency f0 larger than fs over 2, the ideal D2C converter will use the alias frequency which is less than fs over 2. Thus, when we have a mathematical expression, we can use this procedure to describe the conversion process. In case the relative frequency theta 0 is larger than pi, or equivalently, when the original absolute frequency f0 is larger than fs over 2, the conversion uses the alias frequency, which is smaller than fs over 2. In practice, however, we do not have the availability of a mathematical expression of the discrete time signal samples x of n, and the conversion is done with the so-called digital to analog converter, abbreviated as D to A. Such a D to A converter is made from electronic circuitry, and for this reason it will always result in an approximated continuous time or analog signal. There are many different D2A converters. The simplest one is such that for each new sample x of n, the value of the sample is halved during ts seconds, which is a so-called zero-order halt approximation. The result is a continuous time staircase curve. The approximation of the linear D2A converter is somewhat better compared to the zero-order halt case. And as mentioned before, all converters which are used in practice are approximations of the ideal converter. Mathematically, the D2C conversion can be described by the following steps. Use the values of the discrete time samples x of n, which has been obtained at a sample rate of fs is 1 over ts samples a second, in which ts is the intersample distance. Generate for each new position n times ts a continuous time pulse pt minus nts with amplitudes equal to the value of the discrete time sample x of n. Add possible overlapping shifted and weighted pulses according to the given equation, which resolve in an approximated continuous time signal. The pulse shape P of t depends on the characteristics of the D2C converter. For the zero order hold, the pulse shape P of t is equal to 1 during ts second and 0 elsewhere. While for the linear interpolation, the pulse has a triangular shape with duration 2 times ts second. In a follow-up module, we will show that the ideal pulse shape is a sync function, which has infinite duration. In the following animations, we show two different interpolation or reconstruction results. In the first animation, we have sampled a 1 Hz continuous time sine wave, which is depicted as a black dotted line with 3 different sampling rates of respectively 5, 15 and 35 samples a second, or Hz. The discrete time samples are denoted in blue. When applying the zero order hold procedure to reconstruct the continuous time signal, in red, we clearly see the staircase effect of this procedure. It's obvious that we need a high sampling rate to obtain a reasonable smooth reconstruction. The second animation shows the result of a sync interpolation. For this, we use again a 1 Hz continuous time sine wave, in black, which has been sampled, in blue, at 5 samples a second. In order to make the sync reconstruction procedure more visible, the animation shows the intermediate results step by step. In each step, we draw a shifted sync pulse, in green, at the position of the next sample, with an amplitude which equals the value of that particular sample. By adding the different sync pulses, we obtain the reconstructed continuous time signal in red. In theory, it can be shown that when adding all shifted sync pulses from minus up to plus infinity, the sync interpolation equals the ideal interpolation for any sampling frequency fs, which is larger than twice the maximum frequency of the original continuous time signal x of t. This topic will be discussed into more detail in a follow-up module. This ends the video about basics reconstruction. Thank you for your attention.